Hello and welcome to Teaching Computational Thinking to Primary Pupils. I'm from Bangkok Patana School and it's a pleasure to be with you today. The reference and links for today's presentation are available on Scoop.it. There's a lot of links, so I don't expect you to be furiously writing. And I promise the last slide also has the link as well. Internet search, Kidrex. I think it's always worth remembering your internet search. It's not strictly computing, but Kidrex is very useful. But the idea of dealing with strings, searching, it is part of the curriculum. There's a lovely course over here called Welcome to the Web. Again, I've included the link so you can have a look for it and scoop it. And what's nice about this is it takes you right through the basics. Google Search Education. This is not really designed for primary schools, but it includes things like searching by reading level, using the minus, a lot of great functionality in Google that students should know about, and more importantly, you should know about. I don't know how many people know about things like reading age, but I think they are incredible tools. Mozilla Maker. This obviously works best on Firefox, but generally works okay on other Chromebooks. And Mozilla really are making an effort to create maker things, and they do have free tools, activities, and lesson plans on the site. Here's one I put together the other day, Teaching Computational Thinking to Primary Pupils. And it's great fun because you can play with a website, you can play with a real live website, and children think that they've played with the BBC or whatever, and it looks like it because it's taken that code and played with it. And I think it's important for students to understand that the web is supposed to be an open technology, and also how easy it is to make something that looks real but it isn't. Networking. A while back I did a small conference for Google and I showed you how to do the networking. What's nice about networking is it's something that children can go around, they can do it with a pencil and a clipboard, they can do it with an iPad, they can do it with just about anything. And it enables them to understand how all the computers are linked within your school, and beyond that you can show them how they're linked outside of the school. So you can look at things like Graphio. Graphio has a lot of this built in terms of the shapes. Inkpad. Inkpad is completely free, a lovely little vector tool. So if you're doing it on the PC, I did these in Google Draw, so you can go straight in and grab the various bits you need. I have to admit that switch is uncannily accurate. So they really do enable you to draw nicely. Another one is networking. This is made by Cisco, and if you're somebody who uses another type of switch, I think you need to be a bit careful, because as far as they're concerned, Cisco is super cool and the other routers are rubbish. I think it's worth pointing out to the children that it is a commercial, but it is a really nice set of resources and it does explain it in a really nice way. So have a look, but just remember it is made by a commercial company who are keen to sell their product. A few other resources. Google's data center, you can actually have a look around it. There's a whole host of BBC clips. Some are good, some are not so good, but worth it if you want to incorporate that. Network building tool, nice little flash tool for drawing if you don't want to use Google. The story of send, this is a beautiful little story and shows exactly how email gets sent around. And a little video on how submarine cables are laid. I think children have that great curiosity. Well, how is this internet done? How is it? Well, actually, it's really a big set of cables, and I think it's really interesting.
Mm-hmm.